Hi, I'm Dr. Perkins, and today we're going to talk about the scientific method. The scientific method is a series of steps that a scientist goes through when carrying out an experiment. It starts with observing the world around us and asking questions. I observe this plant. Observation is the first step in the scientific method. I notice that it grows over time, and I wonder what conditions will make this plant grow better. So I develop a hypothesis. A hypothesis says if I do X, then Y will happen. A hypothesis is not just a guess, it's an educated guess. In my case, I read about plants growing better with nitrogen. My hypothesis is that if I add nitrogen to the soil, the plant will grow faster. So I add nitrogen to this plant. Nitrogen is called the treatment. But to know if nitrogen had an effect on plant growth, I have to grow another plant without nitrogen. This plant is the control. A control represents a standard for comparison. Both plants are grown under exactly the same conditions so that there is only one variable, the nitrogen. The nitrogen is called the independent variable, and growth is called the dependent variable. It is the variable being measured. Then I collect data. The data represent my results. I see the data, I photograph my data, and here I'm displaying my data as a line graph. From this data, I will draw a set of conclusions. I conclude that plants grow better in the presence of nitrogen. And notice that I have plotted the dependent variable on the y-axis and the independent variable on the x-axis. That is standard. And so from this graph, you can see the red line is plant growing in the presence of nitrogen, and the blue line is the plant growing in the absence of nitrogen. So I have a good conclusion. Is that a good conclusion? Well, sort of. My experiment would have been strengthened if I'd used a population of plants in each group, and that's going to be my next experiment. So thank you for listening.